Let's do now part D of the exercise on normal logic program with variables. So here I have our program P, where I have written the atoms just using their initials and similarly with the constants of the program. So first we have to find the ground instantiation of the program, and I have it already here. And for this first, we write the Hebrand universe that has these three constants, A, B, and E, and then we proceed rule by rule. So these facts, we just copy them. Then this rule has variable x, and then we have to replace it by its element of the Hebrand universe, and this leads us to these three rules, and something similar happens with the next rule. Now, this has two variables, x, y, so then we have to replace them by AA, then by AB, AE, and so on. And this gives us these nine instances. Good, so this is the ground instantiation of the program. Then let's move on and try to find the stable models of this program. So just looking at this program, first we can see that any stable model will have these three atoms. So let's write already here this F equals FAB, FBA, and FEA. Now we know that all the stable models of the program will be a superset of this set, so they will all contain these three atoms because they are facts. And we also know that they will not contain any more atoms of this predicate friend, this predicate F. So then we can simplify these rules here. And we know then we can, the only rules from here that can be applicable are the ones that have this FAB and FBA and FEA, and the rest cannot be applied because there's no way to derive these positive atoms in the body. And this FAB, FBA, and FEA will be true in every stable model, so we can kind of simplify the rules and just think about this part. So from this part of the program, we just have to consider these three small rules, these facts, it's clear that we have them, and then we also have to care about these six rules here that have negation. So let's think about the stable models of the program. So now we cannot derive anything, so let's reason by cases. And on the one hand, let's look for stable models that do not contain IA on one side, and on the other side, for stable models that contain IA. So on the left side, if we do not have IA, then we should have RA for being a model. And but reasoning other way, if we do not have IA, we cannot have IA, because otherwise it would not be a model, and similarly for IA. So then we know that IB cannot be, and IE cannot be either. And now with these two, we can trigger this rule and derive RB and RE. And RA. Right? So then here we have a possible stable model with RA, RB, and RE, and of course these facts, but now I'm not taking care about them anymore because we know they will belong to any answer set. So let's do the reduct, and basically since we have RA, RB, RE, this disappears and this disappears. So we have these three facts that give us the RBE, and this is exactly what we have. So then this is a stable model of the program. We write it down here. Stable model, we have all those facts plus RA, RB, RE. Good. Now let's go to the other side. Here we have I of A. So with I of A, we derive, oops, let me first clean this part here, because the reduct on this part will be different. Okay, let's continue. I have I of A, so I will derive I of B. And given these two, if I have I of, since I have I of A, these two will disappear from the reduct. Hence, there is no way to derive R of A and R of B. So they should not belong to this, to the stable model. And now about the E, we don't know. We have these two rules, but we cannot conclude anything because from here, IA is in the stable model, but it's justified already by other rules, like for example, with this rule. So then we can reason by cases and see what would happen if IE was not there and what would happen if it was indeed there. So for this not I of E, we derive R of E. And that's it. So now we have to check whether the stable model that has these three, the interpretation that has these three, is indeed a stable model. So let's do the reduct. So here we get rid of these two rules. And here this one. And here we do like this. And here like that. So then we can derive R, E, I, A, I, B, and nothing else from here. So just these three facts, which are exactly the three that we have. Hence, this is a stable model. Good. And now let's move to the other side. And here we have IE. So with IE, this will disappear from the reduct, so there's no way to derive R of E, so R of E should be false. And then let's see whether this interpretation is indeed a stable model. Again, we get rid of these two rules, and also of this one, because we have I of E. And then here, all this R is false, we are left with this. That allows us to derive IA, IB, IE, which is exactly what we had. So indeed, this is a stable model. Then let's write it here. And this is the nice case where all are invited to the party. And good. Yeah, so these are the three stable models of the program. So I hope this was clear to you. You have understood it, and also you enjoyed it. And then see you in another video. Ciao!